Growing up in Kenya in the 90s was so simple and so real, at least for us children. There was no technology. We were just communicating and being in each other's business 24 hours a day, at least 18 hours a day. We played games like Kati, Kalongolongo, Blada, Round Us, Shake, 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 and so many more.
Welcome back to my channel. I go by the name Vivian Odhiambo, aka Fashion Guru Kenya, aka Mtoto wa Homa Bay County. As I was saying, in the 90s, we had so many games to play and so little time. We played games like Kalongolongo, Kati, Round Us, Mfea, Mfarago, Ndisinya. There were so many games to play and so little time. Like 24 hours wasn't enough. So every day we went to sleep with unfinished business. Because someone beat me in Kati yesterday. I needed to go back to being number one in Kati. Someone beat me in Blood. Like, we always had unfinished business when we went to sleep. And it's like we had, you see the way you're adults now and you plan on what you're going to do tomorrow. Okay, we used to plan, like, kesho tunacheza Kati, tomorrow we are playing this, tomorrow we are playing that. Like, we had so much time, eh? No technology, no internet, just you and your friends in each other's business 24 hours a day. Eh?
And this right here used to be called Dufomparo. We used to go to stagnant water, swim.
Dufomparo. That was everything. Dufomparo. Dufomparo. We used to go jump in dirty water, Aki. Actually, we are so lucky that we didn't have any skin diseases. We used to go jump in dirty water and then wear back our clothes and go back home. And then those days, showering was a chore. So, chore. Ilikuwa kazi, yani, guy, English. Ilikuwa kazi. So we used to come back in the evening. You come back late, it's cold, and then because you didn't shower when there was sun, your mother would force you to shower with that cold water at that particular time because she had told you to shower early, but you didn't. So you'd go to the bathroom and do a passport, wash your hands, your leg, your neck, and your face where your parent could see you. But then our mothers got clever and they were like, these people, do they really shower? So they would always touch our backs. If your back was warm, that means you didn't shower. So go back to the shower. Like, do kids still do this? Like, our childhood was so lit, and guy, it was.
Then there was this game, Banu, where Banu was just.
I loved playing Banu. Banu was the it. And then we used to use words like cracking open, jikide, jikide, cracking open. Up to now, I don't know what jikide means, but all I know, I don't know where that name jikide came from, but jikide was you placing your bano somewhere so that someone can start playing. And then cracking open means if I crack your bano, I'm not paying for it. And then we used to play games where if I play and win, I take your bano, yeah? And then I earn, and I'll have more and more banos. I don't know why these things were called banos, but that was our childhood, Banu.
After a long day of playing and playing hide and seek with our parents in the shower, it was time to sit down and catch up with our favorite TV shows. Who remembers these TV shows? Let me know.
Harry, wir brauchen den Wagen sofort.
Detective Derek. And then there was Sinbad. There was wrestling. To me was Stone Cold and The Rock. All these things we used to watch on our Great Wall televisions. Sinbad used to come on Sunday afternoon after you're from church, eh? You'd watch Sinbad, Tarzan, and the likes. And then Stone Cold Steve Austin wrestling, it was called WF. It used to come on Tuesday 7:30 or 8 p.m. And then there was SmackDown on Sunday. I mean, hey, our weekend was lit, yani. The match between The Rock and Stone Cold used to be it. You see the way people wait for Akiani, Manu, and Arsenal. That is the way we used to wait for the match between Stone Cold and The Rock. Do you smell what The Rock is cooking? Stone Cold Steve Austin 316. Let me just show you the glitz, man. then there was Ridiculous. I believe it was Sunday in the evening. Like
Ridiculous. These guys were just plain mad. These guys used to do things and you're looking at them like, we used to laugh. And it was fun. But Ridiculous was just another thing. Like, Ridiculous was that comedy that you couldn't miss watching because it was awesome.
Our weekends were packed with games and lit television shows.
Catherine Casavoli. Since 1991, KTN has been transmitting on Channel 62. Over the years, KTN has worked towards being your number one station. From 1991 to date.
As I said earlier, these ones were plain mad. Now, this is a guy who's dressed like a lady, and the way they used to manage to look exactly like women. Here he was playing a role of Catherine Casavoli. Catherine Casavoli used to be the queen of TV back in the day.
And then there was this TV show that you were not allowed to watch. It was called The Bold and the Beautiful. They had Rich, Brooke, Stephanie, Eric, and Taylor. Brooke used to be that woman. She scattered an entire family in this TV series. I don't know how I knew about this. Don't tell my parents. But we're not allowed to watch this one. And then we had TV adverts.
Oh, the TV advertisements were lit back when Kenya Airways was Kenya Airways. And this song, Blue Band song, this one used to give kids like stress because you wanted your mom to buy that blue band so that you can grow. But you see, where I grew up, there was no that it's either you chose, you wanted bread or blue band, like you couldn't have them both, you had to choose. It was hard, but we just had to watch it on TV, and that is what made me even work harder, because I was working towards like one day I want to be able to afford this blue band. So
step by step, day by day, growing stronger along the way. Blue Band gives them the energy to grow.
I used to work so hard in school because those days education was the only key. Like the only key. That was the only key you needed to open so that you can be successful. Eh?
And there was this advertisement that Masimara was in. As we used just to sing because the song was nice, but we didn't know what they were advertising, what things were, these things were going to be used for. Eh?
Let's, oh yeah, let's talk.
Let's talk about all, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that may be. Let's talk about us. Let's talk about trust.
And then in the 90s, we used to have power plays too. We used to have power, and two things determined how much of power you were going to have. One, food, and two, electronics. And that time, Chapo was still a virgin. Chapo was a rare gem. We never used to eat it like all the time. Like nowadays, you pass everywhere and there's chapati. It was special. So, if you're eating chapo that day, you'd go and tell all your friends, everyone out there, you're eating chapo. And that is when the power games would begin. Because the only a chosen few will be allowed into your queendom or your kingdom. You'd choose your friends, those ones that you like, and you'd give them chapati or allow them to sit with you in the kitchen as you watch your mama cook chapati. That was the queendom right there. That was the place where every kid needed to play. And this is the time where friendships were made or broken, because the people that you didn't choose would make form their own alliance. And then us that were chosen would form our own alliance. So tomorrow when you are playing, we are divided again. It was hectic. It was tiring. We are divided because of chapatis, imagine. We're not speaking to each other because of chapatis. And then another power play number two. If you had a VCR recorder, that thing was everything. Now, if you had this in your house, you are the queen bee. You are the king bee of that area. You owned every little kid in that area, because Where were they going to watch Rambo, Commando, Shaolin the Temple? Where if not in your house? So they had no choice but to respect you, because where are they going to watch all these things? So we had to speak to the person that owned these things.
vizuri, because if you don't speak to them nicely, you never get to see these things. You only hear them from other kids saying, oh, yesterday we went to Kinanani, they played this, we played this. And people who own these things, eh? The VCRs and colored TV were considered wadosi. Wadosi means rich. Kinanani ni wadosi, wakona VCR, ya kweka tape, wakona VCR, that one, ya tape. Wakona tape recorder, alafu wakona TV colored. Au ni wadosi kwa shina, ni amna TV colored. Any, those were the things that we used to talk about. Like our childhood was all about power play. Who was more worth than the other, who was more worth than the other. And I think, looking back at it, all these things have come to haunt us when you're growing up. And this is what is happening in the current generation with social media. Because everyone is trying to play these power games on social media. As we used to play live, like with simple things like chapatis, VCRs, a fridge, you know, such things, Christmas clothes, and now it's on the internet. Now this generation, levels don't change, eh? They are doing it on the internet, eh? But the 90s were the days. Oh, they were the days. So tell me, if you grew up in the 1990s and 2000s, if you're a kid and a teenager within that, between that time, eh? So what did you guys do? How was it? Were the games the same? Just leave your comments in the comment section below. Just let me know how you guys grew up. Because me, my childhood was lit. Let me see you on my next one. Bye-bye. Don't forget to subscribe.